our humanity. It's all about humanity.
All right, guys, we are good to go now. Both players had a little warm-up time. They are going to lag for the break, so we'll go ahead and look at this view here. Let's take a look at our overhead. All right, guys, and it looks like Kenny Nguyen is going to be breaking the first strike. This is a rack your own event. I've got both information sheets here provided by Jacob Watson from the Ark-La-xT Classic. We have Sean King from Oklahoma City. And Kenny Nguyen from McAllen, Texas. Sean King traveled 400 miles for this event, and he does not have any sponsors officially, according to his questionnaire. Wants to give a shout out to Eileen, the love of his life, and his mother. Hopefully they're watching on the stream right now. This is a 100% free stream. This is not like our free previews from our action matches. We will be free throughout the entire thing. So go ahead and hit that notify button. That way you can be notified when we do go live. And Ken Nguyen here at the table. He is from McAllen, Texas, down south the way. I call it North Mexico. He traveled about 400 miles for this tournament, and he wants to say thank you to his sponsors, Doc's Billiards Office and King of the Slate. Well, he came out okay here. Take a look at that overhead. Yeah, that's going to be a tough one to get to. See if Sean can manage something here. Let's get our scoreboard up there. Sorry about that, guys. And again, this is a 100% free stream, so go ahead and share. First chance to see Sean King at the table. Able to kick that ball, and he's gonna get. Ooh, is he gonna get safe? That's gonna be a tough one. See if we can't get a good view. Kenny kicking at this ball. If Sean can make this ball, I feel like he's definitely going to get the out here. I don't see any big issues. Now, guys, these are Valley bar tables with standard pockets. So they are pretty big pockets. However, they are deceivingly tight as far as the cut goes on the pocket angle. Thank you. And it looks like this first rack is going to go to Sean King here. Smooth stroke by Sean there. Very, very nice. Sean gonna take the first game. While he's racking the balls, let's take a look at this other table over here. We've got Paul Hedrick and Doug Winnett. Sean King breaking. Let's take a look at our overhead. This is hand racked with a wooden rack or a plastic rack, a hard plastic. No template. See what happens here. Now, keep in mind, guys, the nine ball does not count anywhere, no matter where it goes. So that ball is just going to spot back up, and it's going to be Sean's shot on the two ball. Give a shout to Ed Puente and Gabriel Chamberlain. Both guys down in the Rio Grande Valley. We will be down there next week for Federgorst versus Ko Pin Yi. That's going to be a very, very good match. I'll show you guys that flyer here in just a minute. Got a pretty favorable kiss there. He's shooting the wrong ball and Kenny doesn't even know. Did he shoot the wrong ball? Maybe he didn't. It looked like the five. Sean, we will have the total on the players auction here in just a little while. I believe it's right around 47,000 in the auction. I will get an answer for that. I think they are still calculating everything up and double and triple checking. But I believe it is right around the 47,000 mark. So our next event here is going to be SVB versus, actually that's not our next event. Our actual next event is Kopeny versus Vettergorst. And that's going to be in Harlingen, Texas at the Rockin' Q. Following that, we will be in Las Vegas, Nevada with SVB and Tony T-Rex Chohan. And then shortly thereafter, headed to the Cajun Coast Classic in Morgan City, Louisiana. Just take a look at the break here. Got a moving break there by Kenny Nguyen, but no balls down. Sean King playing a roll out there. Missed it, but he missed it on the good side, I believe. Let's take a look at the overhead. I don't know if he can get through there. And it looks like he might be looking to go rail first. Not exactly what he wanted there. Thank you. What's up, Nordstrom? How you doing, buddy? Sorry, guys, doing some adjustments on the cameras. We had an issue last night, so the you locked that one in. You're going to feel good about that one. Last night, we are sitting here doing the mini tournament that was not streamed. And I think we're at the 5th, 6th place matches. And all of a sudden, the power goes out. And we kind of laugh it off, you know, whatever. And we, after about 10, 15 minutes of no power, we're like, oh, what's going on here? And we walk out back, and the power pole that provides power to the pool hall is laying on the ground. Luckily, the energy company came out and quickly, very quickly, got it fixed for us by morning time so we could have the tournament. But every bit of adjustments I made on the cameras last night kind of got reset, and we've been working through trying to get them back to where they were today. Unfortunately, I've also been doing a lot of other stuff, including the auction as well as a bunch of others. So, crazy night last night, but we're here, we're live, we're rocking and rolling. This is a first round match with Kenny Nguyen and Sean King. Over on our secondary table, which we'll take a look at here in just a minute, it's Paul Hedrick and Doug Winnette. And it looks like here, with a very tough miss, Sean King is going to give up the table to Kenny Nguyen. Give Kenny a chance to get on the board here. Doug Winnette and Paul Hedrick playing on the next side over. Kenny gets a game there. Let me get that scoreboard updated. Thank you. Daniel Morton, not yet. We do not know the total auction yet. They're still working through that. I don't want to rush them on it. We can get that information at any point in time. We got a long tournament to go, so don't know the information yet. Looks like Kenny's going to have to bank this ball and maybe even go around 1, 2, 3 rails and come out. I don't think he can hold it. I don't think he'd want to try. Okay, okay, it must pass the 9. Let me look at the overhead. Yeah, it passes the 9. I was thinking it didn't pass. All right, guys, so it's funny. I just had that conversation with you about the power going out last night. So I just found out that after this match, they actually have to cut the power to the venue for about 30 minutes. This is completely out of our hands. This is something the power company said, hey, we have to do. They gave us the option to... they said, hey, we can wait until you're ready, because we know you'll have a big event going on, but we got to do it sometime in the next hour and a half, 2 hours. So... after the first round of matches, which is what we're seeing on the stream right now, we're actually going to have to cut the stream and cut the power for 30 minutes. So that's an interesting turn of events. Sucks. Nothing we can do about it. So no, not right now. It's going to happen after this match. After this match. The power company came and said, hey, we have to do this. When can we do it in the next 2 hours? And the decision was made that we would do it after the first round matches are done. So we won't be able to move on to another match on the stream table because we do not have any matches left. We're playing almost all the available matches currently. So... No use in risking putting another match up and it going long and then we have to cut it in the middle of it and things get a little crazy. So, Randy, the bracket is on challenge.com. I don't have the exact, link. However, if you go to Jacob Watson, his Facebook page, he has posted that link. and you can go and check out the bracket. I may be able to pull it up here in a few minutes. Before we cut the power, I may be able to pull up the bracket and show you guys what we're looking at if you can't find it. It should be pretty easy. Jacob Watson, his Facebook page will have that link. And, yeah, I agree, David. Better sooner than later. Like I said, the freak accident last night, the power pole snapped in half, and they had to come out and put another one up and reattach everything. And apparently now they're telling us, hey, we got to cut it here in just a little while. So we'll get it cut, and we'll come back, and we'll be ready for some round two matches. No harm, no foul. We're on. Actually, we're ahead of schedule. This will be a late night, but you know, we kind of knew that going in, that it was going to be a late night tonight. So only 97 players. So gonna go pretty smoothly. Sean King here on the working on the run out. Important shot here. Needs to get in a favorable position with the five, and he really didn't. It's kind of a tough spot here. Yeah, I will, David. I'll pull it up here in just a minute. Daniel, we're using 16 tables. They have a few more, but we're leaving some open for practice. I believe their total is, I think they have 21 or 22, but they're only using 16 to keep some open for practice. Guys, bear with me for just a second while I... This, you're going to see something pop up on your screen right after he shoots this shot. I will take it away as soon as possible. I got it before it popped up. Ooh, I'm fast like that, guys. Quick, guys, I don't have a whole lot of time to do it, so give me just a second. All right, let's see here. I'm going kind of quickly. There's going to be a couple good matches coming up. I'm going to go ahead and close this back out. But we'll take a look at more of it here in just a few minutes. Yeah, Daniel, I can do that. Give me just a moment. See if I can get this on here. See here. See if that one works, guys. Sean King making quick work of this one. Guys, I'll be right back. Guys, don't forget our next event, Fedegors versus Copin Yee. That's going to be in the Rio Grande Valley down in Harlingen, Texas at the Rockin' Q. Going to be a crazy, crazy match. November 12th and 13th, it's 9-ball race to 60 over 2 days. Nine ranked on the spot with an AccuRec. Break from the box on a 9-foot diamond. If you would like to get seats to that, talk to Benito Garcia at the Rockin' Q. It is 3-3 and in this race to 7. Dry break, but it may have come out favorable. I don't know if he can get through that. That's a tight one, especially when he's tree-topped over that ball. Fire. All right, guys, a little bit of update. So the power's good for the next 3 to 4 hours, roughly. They will give us an update as far as when it needs to be cut. They'll give us an hour advance time notice. So they'll say, hey, we're going to cut the power in an hour. Make sure your matches are done, and we'll get that done. So that's good news for us. Look at that kick, and he just didn't get rewarded. How crazy is that? Look at this nine ball. Yeah. That's just brutal right there. So 4-3. Kenny Nguyen versus Sean King. Take a look at our second table over here. Looks like Paul Hedrick is racking. I do not know the score. I don't see coins on the table. Take that scoreboard off. Well, we can see that Paul Hedrick is at 4. Don't know where Doug is. Back to our main table here. Big break by Sean King. Quick work of that one. Go back to our view on top of the booth. Doug Winnett shooting at the three ball. Oh, and he just doesn't get rewarded there. That's brutal. Guys, and obviously we still have a very competitive match going on here, but our next match is going to be a doozy. It's going to be Daniel Herring from the DFW area versus Clint Freeman, who is now in the DFW area, formerly resided right here in Shreveport, Louisiana. So make sure that you don't go anywhere. We will cut the stream off, but we will cut it back on as soon as those two players are ready to roll. Ouch. Sean King taking a really good look at this one. Can't squeeze in behind it without clipping the five ball, so he's going to have to kick at it. Well, and it looks like Kenny Wynn's going to take this one down. He is on the rail, but it shouldn't be an issue. Take your time. Yeah, good shot. Bar box nine ball can sometimes be a crapshoot, but it does still take skill to get out of some of the situations that occur, so. Once again, guys, the nine ball does not count. It is just going to be spotted. And there it is, Sean King, tying it up 5-5. Take a look at our booth top camera, right on top of my booth here, pointing over at our secondary table, where as soon as that match is done, we'll have Ryan Brazelman and Justin Espinoza on the second stream table. Kenny Wynn here breaking off on the 11th rack. Kenny looks like he's struggling on his break a little bit. Hasn't really been able to make that ball that he's needed, but he's been coming out pretty okay. Thank you. just going to roll out there. Didn't have a good shot. I'm not sure what he can manage here. Guys, I'm going to let them play this rack out. I'll be right back. I got to take a very, very quick break. Thank you. Well, and if Sean can manage to get out here, you can't help but enjoy the fact that our very first stream match of the day is going to be a hill thriller. Kenny's gone gold. And when he makes this nine ball, Sean King is also going to go gold. Looks like over on the next table over, Justin Espinoza and Ryan Brazelman getting ready to start their first round match. We'll keep an eye on that as we go. But right now, we got a hill thriller. Kenny Nguyen versus Sean King. Oh. Can you see all of this ball? He definitely could. And there it is. First match of the day on the TV table. Hill. Pretty strong there. Good match. It's what we like to see. I love the Hills. So, Sean King winning that one. We're going to go ahead and reset these scores, get new players up. Guys, we are going to cut off the stream, and we will be right back. See you guys on the short side.